the window of our kitchen, we can look through a gap between trees to a wooden stable in Tona's courtyard. This stable, along with the old house and barn, makes such a satisfying arrangement that it is hard to believe that these three structures were not planned and built all at the same time. Instead, what has become the stable was at one time a family home, and in another part of the village.
To je kuća od Janka Fudurića, pa je kupljena u Argentini, u Buenos Airesu. A to je moj svekar kupl. I dalje 100.000 za nju. I to je onda...
By the mid-1960s, Tona's grandfather, Marko, was also in Argentina. And it was there, in Buenos Aires, that Marko concluded the deal to buy the empty house, which was in our village, from Janko. Marko then gave the house to Tona's parents, Ivan and Jana. And it is Jana who is now telling this story.
Da ostala nam za štavu, da, tako. Pa imamo kravu I tele u njoj I tako, da. A on je bil tamo godma mi, onda je Janko došao tamo I onda tako on kupil tu kuću.
Here is a picture of Janko Fudorić. He is seen here dressed as a waiter in the local cafe in our village. His father, also called Janko, had lived in Baka Jana's house until he moved out and built the little wooden house a few meters away, under one of the very large and old pear trees that line the road. After some years, the father emigrated to Argentina with his wife Dragica. Their son, Janko, remained alone in the village. When later Janko tried to join his family in South America, he was caught attempting to leave the country without permission, and consequently spent a year in prison. Upon his release, however, he was allowed to join his parents, and emigrated around the beginning of the 1960s, and where he later met Marko. Janko, the father, never came back to the village again, but for his son, it was to prove an emotional return.
A bila prije baš kuća?
To bila njegova kuća od Janka Fudurića.
A gdje je to bila?
A to doli, to te u kadidarku ima skriža. Tamo je to bilo.
Aha, ispod da. One kruške?
Da, da. Mm-hmm. On je kad je došao je jedan put, spok je tamo otišao, došao je doma. I onda je klekao na prag štale. I kušun je prag, kako mu bilo milo kad je došao u obajt kuću, da. I njegova čiji je bila dva put, Silvija se zvala, ime je bilo Silvija. I ona je broj od kuće zela I odnesla u Argentinu, da. Rekla da će još dojti, a još je bila jedan put, ali posle je nije bilo. Posle se udala I tako nije došla više, da.
A tko je donio kuću tu?
A mi smo raskopali pa smo ju dopeljali.
Da. Komad po komad.
A da, da. A brvanje se raskopa, tije banjke, pa se tako došli su. Pa smo tako, da, to. I onda smo složili ju, da. I tako to ostala kuća, da. Da. Ovdje je bio ambar njegov, a tamo je... Bila kuća, da. Tamo je I kuvali su u kući, da.
A koliko ljudi su živjeli u toj kući?
Bil je njegov otac, isto se zval Janko, I mat Dragica. Njih dva su bili. Ali su oni prošli još prije u Argentinu. Pa su onda njega I primili tamo, da. A još je jedan brat bil Mija, A taj je u ratu negdje nestao, ne zna se za njega nigdar, da. To je bilo, da. I to je sve bilo u toj jelinoj kući, onda su se podijelili, onda su oni sebi to napravili malu tu kućicu i tako su bili da. U tem. Da.
Ali ta kuća je malo mlađa od, od jedine kuće.
A da, da, je mlađa, je, da.
Jeste li vi pomagli nositi kuću?
Je, je, da, da, jesam, kako da ne.
I, koliko ste imali godinu tada?
Ka ja? O, imala sam 35, a još sam mlada onda bila, da. Da.
Onda odmah krava se preselila?
Da, 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 odmah.
We can no longer see any physical evidence that a house ever stood on this site. But thankfully we have Baka Jana's story and our imagination to go by. And the row of quince trees which still blossom, and the fruit which still falls to the ground each year, unclaimed.